Hare Hare. All right, so we're going through the 11th canto. We're on the first chapter about how the Yadu dynasty were all cursed.
我们已经讲到第十一篇，第十一篇，亚德王朝是如何遭到诅咒的？
All right, so it's described in the Bhagavad Gita that people who are very attached to the words of the Vedas, they do the worship for going just for the purpose of going to the heavenly planet.
在《佛教梵歌》里讲到，那些一心一意的遵守伟大仪式的人们，他们想要去天堂。
And they think that sense gratification and opulent life is the goal of life.
他们认为感官享乐和富裕的生活是他们生活的目标。
So, the Vedic literatures are meant, the Vedic literature does award people sense gratification to the conditioned soul.
伟达文献确实可以给受条件限制的灵魂以感官享乐。
And it also helps a person to be obedient to the Vedic teaching.
它也能够帮助人们服从伟达的教导。
But because the Vedas give sense gratification, that is a it's, it's a dangerous thing.
但是因为伟达经它赐予人们感官享乐，而感官享乐是非常危险的。
Because what happens is the living entity becomes entangled in material enjoyment.
因为受条件限制的灵魂，他们会纠缠于感官享乐中。
And he forgets what the real purpose of the Veda.
以至于他们忽视了伟大经的终极目标。
The real purpose of the Vedas is to bring the living entity back to Godhead.
伟达文献的终极目标是使个体生物回归神首。
And to help the person to come to originate pure consciousness that he's a servant of a servant of Krishna.
帮助受条件限制的灵魂恢复他们的知觉，他们作为至尊主永恒仆人的知觉。
And if he becomes Krishna conscious, then he can go to the spiritual world and he can enjoy unlimited bliss there.
如果他们具备了 Krishna 知觉，就可以回归神首那里，得享无穷的灵性喜乐。
So when one is serious about advancing in Krishna consciousness, he can hear the Vedic literature. He can hear about devotional service.
真诚渴望在 Krishna 之觉中积极上进的人，应该聆听伟达文献，聆听奉献服务。
But he should hear from those people who are devotees, who are advanced in Krishna consciousness.
他们应该从Krishna 之觉高度精进的奉献者那里聆听。
And he should avoid things which he should avoid speculating about the material enjoyment.
应该避免。
He should avoid. You should avoid materialistic desires for enjoyment.
他应该避免物质享受的欲望。
So he has to be, we have to be able to see the difference between the temporary affairs of this world and the transcendental activities of Krishna.
我们应该能够看清这世间短暂事物以及 Krishna 的超然活动之间的分别。
And we have to devote ourselves to the service of the Lord, and that will take away all the darkness which is covering our heart.
我们该奉献于对主的服务，这样才能去除内心的物质覆盖。
We should give up the desire for sense gratification.
我们要放弃感官享乐的愿望。
Sense gratification comes in two forms. One is sinful activities, the other is pious activities.
感官享乐以两种形式呈现，一种是罪恶活动，一种是虔诚活动。
So both sin and piety are done for our own personal sense gratification.
不管是从事罪恶还是虔诚活动，都是为了个人的享乐。
The real happiness is in giving pleasure to Krishna.
而真正的快乐是取悦 Krishna。
And Lord Krishna will take the fortunate living entity back home to his own abode, to the spiritual world.
主 Krishna 就会把这幸运的生物带回他灵性世界的自身的居所。
Krishna will first of all give the sincere soul an opportunity to hear about his pastime.
Krishna 会首先赐予幸运的灵魂聆听他逍遥时光的机会。
And when the devotee has advanced, then he'll be naturally attracted to these pastimes.
当奉献者变得精进的时候，会自发地受这些逍遥时光吸引。
And then at that time, Krishna gives him the opportunity to take part in his pastime.
那时，主便赐予他机会参与他上演，参与他，使他参与上演逍遥时光。
And these pastimes are the living entity will go to the place within this material world where Krishna is performing his pastimes, and he'll take part in his pastimes.
这个生物会去主在这个宇宙，在某个宇宙上演逍遥时光的地方，去参加那里的逍遥时光。
So when we get to take part in the pastimes of Krishna, then we completely forget about the material world. We become detached from the material world.
当我们去参与主的逍遥时光的时候，就会彻底的超脱这个物质世界。
At that time, Krishna brings us to his own abode in the spiritual sky.
最终，主会把我们，他带回灵性天空，主的栖身居所。
The foolish people cannot understand the benefit given by Krishna.
愚蠢之人不能明白 Krishna 给予的恩赐。
But Krishna acts for the benefit of all of us to save us from becoming absorbed in the temporary material world.
主 Krishna 前来，把我们从这短暂的世界中拯救出来。
Krishna shows his own transcendental beauty and transcendental words and transcendental activity.
Krishna 展示他超然的俊美、超然的话语和超然的活动。
And although Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago, if anyone chants and hears about the form and the activities of Krishna, you'll get the same benefit as those who were personally with Krishna 5,000 years ago.
虽然主 Krishna 显现在5000年前。谁若聆听和唱诵主的活动、形体和话语，必会获得曾经亲身和主在同一时代，经历了主 Krishna 时代的事情的人，得到了同样的福祉。
Done this way, we can cross over the dark material existence and go to Krishna's own abode.
以这种方式，我们能跨越物质存在的黑暗，到达主的居所。
So we can understand if it's possible for anybody to go there, then it must have certainly been possible for the Yadavas, because the Yadavas were all personal associates of Krishna.
我们能可以得出结论。 倘若众生都能到达那里的话，作为主的亲身同游，亚度族人，他们无疑早已到达了。
Just by Krishna's own beauty, he took away the vision of people who saw him. Everyone would become completely lost in the beauty of Krishna, just seeing him.
通过看到Krishna 与他的俊美，盗走了见到他的美丽的人们的视欲，人们就会忘我，浑然忘我。
And Krishna's speaking was so attractive that everyone who heard him became speechless.
Krishna 的话语如此吸引人心，使得聆听的人们都变得目瞪口呆。
Now, those people who cannot speak, they're usually also deaf.
通常那些不能说话的人，他们都已经就几乎就死了。
So Krishna's words also took away the ears of everyone who heard him.
Krishna 的话语还盗走了聆听者的耳朵。
What happens is the people were no longer interested in hearing any sound other than Krishna speaking.
这就使得他们对聆听到 Krishna 话语的人们，他们对其他的声音都不再感兴趣了。
And then Krishna also showed the beauty of his footsteps.
Krishna 还展示了他步伐的美丽。
And everyone who saw them, then Krishna took away the power to perform materialistic activity.
亲眼目睹 Krishna 步伐美丽的人们，就丧失了从事物质活动的能力。
And by his appearance in this world, Krishna took away the senses of men.
Krishna 通过他的亲身临在，拿走了人们的感官。
Krishna made people blind, dumb, deaf, mad.
Krishna 使得人们变得又聋又哑又跛，甚至疯狂。
So, because Krishna took away everything which people possessed, we may say, well, Krishna is not very merciful. He is just a thief.
因为 Krishna 拿走了人们的一切，有人会说 Krishna 根本就不仁慈，他简直是个贼。
So actually, this is offering a praise to the beauty of Krishna.
这实际上是在赞美 Krishna 的美丽。
Because although Krishna gave liberation to the devotees by destroying them, but to those who were attracted to him, Krishna gave pure love of God.
虽然 Krishna 通过消灭恶魔赐予他们解脱，但对那些被他吸引的人，Krishna 赐予他们神爱。
Krishna drowned them in the ocean of his own beauty.
Krishna 把他们淹没在他自身美丽的海洋。
So Krishna is not like a person who gives charity without any caring. Some people, they just give charity without thinking who they're giving it to. But Krishna is not like that.
有的人布施的时候根本就不加分辨，Krishna 不是这种人。
But Krishna is very merciful. He gave the highest benediction to the people of the earth.
Krishna 非常仁慈，他把最高的福祉赐给了地球居民。
And he empowered people like Vyasadeva to write his pastimes in beautiful poetry.
Krishna 还授权 Vyasadeva 以优美的诗文描述他的逍遥。
So people born on the earth in the future, they could easily hear the glories of Krishna and pass over the ocean of birth and death.
未来诞生在地球上的人们，通过聆听 Krishna 的荣耀，能轻易跨越生死之痒。
They could pass over the ocean of birth and death by going on the boat of the transcendental pastimes of Krishna.
Krishna 的消失刚，好比坚固的船舶，人们通过这艘船舶能跨越生死之痒。
So those people who are enjoying the glories of Krishna by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada, are also very fortunate to get the mercy of Krishna.
通过。是的，Prabhupada 的仁慈，人们欣赏到 Krishna 的荣耀，所以是 Krishna 仁慈的幸运接受者。
So Krishna was merciful even to people who were yet to. Who were not born yet.
所以 Krishna 甚至对那些还没有出生的人们也非常仁慈。
Thank you. So Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he says, he says that there are different meanings, there are many different meanings for some of the words.
Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur，他说有些词含义深刻。
And he describes, he says that the Bhagavatam says that Krishna went to his abode.
佛教法坛说到，Krishna 去了他自身的居所。
But it could also mean that Krishna had been away from his home and he was now returning.
换句话说，Krishna 离开了家，他现在回家了。
So it's not proper, however, to say that Krishna went back to his home, because Krishna is always present in his home in the spiritual world.
说 Krishna 回家了，这也不是很恰当，因为 Krishna 是永远就留在家中的。
And from time to time in the material world, Krishna would manifest himself.
而 Krishna 时不常的，他就在物质世界展示自己。
God is everywhere. So he can be present before us, and at the same time he can be in his own abode.
因为神无处不在，他既可以在我们面前，他也可以在他自己的居所。
But the jiva, the living entity, is not all-pervading. Jiva is not like the super soul.
但是个体灵魂并不像神一样，可以遍存万有。
And if the jiva is present in the material world, then he is absent from the spiritual world.
倘若个体灵魂它在物质世界，它就不在灵性世界了。
It's the fact that we're suffering due to having to wait.
的的确确的，我们因为离开了家而受苦。
So Krishna got what he desired.
Krishna 会如愿以偿。
Krishna is all-pervading and he's self-sufficient.
Krishna 遍存万有，他也是自足的。
And his appearance and disappearance in this world can never be compared to the common people.
他在这世上的显现和隐迹，永远不能和普通人永远不能和他同日而语。
So we can never compare his activities to an ordinary person.
我们永远不应该把 Krishna 的活动和普通人的活动相提并论。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Uddhava compares the disappearance of Lord Krishna to the setting of the sun.
在圣典波迦瓦坛，Uddhava 把 Krishna 的隐迹比作太阳落山。
So comparing Krishna to the sun is a very good example. Just like when the sun sets, then darkness comes everywhere in the world.
把 Krishna 比喻为太阳是非常贴切的，太阳一落山，夜幕便自动降临。
So Lord Krishna appears and disappears in many. In an infinite number of universes in the material world.
Krishna 在无数的物质宇宙中显现和隐迹。
And as long as he's in one universe, he can't go to another universe. As when Krishna's in one universe, he cannot just go off to another universe without permission.
如果 Krishna 在一个宇宙，没有允许，他就不能去另一个宇宙。
And when he leaves one universe, then that universe will be put into darkness.
当 Krishna 离开Krishna 隐迹的那个宇宙就被置于黑暗之中。
But Krishna is always present in some universe, just like the sun is always present in the sky.
Krishna 始终莅临某个宇宙，就像太阳始终在天空。
The sun is present either in India or America. But when the sun is in India, then America is in darkness. And when the sun is in America, then India is in darkness.
太阳时而出现在印度，时而出现在美国。当太阳在印度的时候，美国就在黑暗中；当太阳在美国的时候，印度就在黑暗之中。
We should understand that the Lord's abode is as eternal as Krishna himself.
我们要明白，Krishna 的居所跟 Krishna 本人一样是永恒的。
The ocean swallowed Dwarka and it took away the Lord's personal abode, which Krishna had abandoned.
当海洋吞没了多尔卡城，他就卷走了主的亲身居所。
The Supreme Lord, who is also known as Madhusudan, is always present in Dwarka.
至尊主，他也被称为马杜苏丹，他永远存在于多尔卡。
So it's the most auspicious place. Just as the sun appears to be swallowed by the night, Krishna or his abode, it appears to disappear. It seems like it's disappearing.
Dwarka 是最吉祥的地方，仿佛太阳似乎被夜色吞没，Krishna 或他的居所，或他的王朝看似消失了。
But actually, Krishna and all of his paraphernalia and his holy abode and all the members of his dynasty, they're all eternal, just as the sun is always in the sky.
事实上，主和他的所有随身物，包括他的居所、王朝，都是永恒的，就像太阳始终在天空。
So, in the same way, Krishna disappears in one universe. That's the beginning of his pastimes in another place.
同样，主 Krishna 从某个宇宙隐迹的同时，就意味着他在另一个宇宙开始上演一组逍遥时光。
As soon as one pastime is finished here, then he goes to another universe.
这里的逍遥时光一结束，他便在另一个宇宙当中开始了。
So his Nitya Lila are going on without end.
他的 Nitya Lila 永恒的上演着，永不停息。
So Maharaj Parikshit asked a question to Sukadeva Goswami. He said, "How could the Brahmanas curse the Yadu dynasty, who were always respectful to the Brahmanas?"
Maharaj Parikshit 就询问 Shukadeva Goswami 说：“婆罗门们怎么会诅咒威士忌族人呢？他们始终敬重 Brahmana。”
Yeah, there the. The Vrishni, the Yadu dynasty, were always respectful and charitable, and they were inclined to serve the senior and exalted personalities.
威士忌族人，也就是亚杜族人，始终敬重 Brahmana，乐善好施，侍奉长者和高尚人士。
And their minds were always absorbed in thought of Krishna.
并且他们始终全心全意地想着主 Krishna。
So Brahmanas, sometimes we see Brahmanas, they become angry at people who are not respectful to them.
Brahmana 通常都对不尊重 Brahmana 阶层的人愤怒。
And if people are not very charitable to them, and if they don't show proper respect, then the Brahmanas may get angry at them.
倘若人们并不乐善好施，并且不尊重他们，这些 Brahmana 会感到愤怒。
But the Yadu dynasty were not like that.
但是亚杜王朝的人可不是这种人。
The Brahmanas, the Yadu dynasty were sincere followers of the Brahminical culture.
亚杜族人都是 Brahmana 文化的忠实追随者。
Even if the Brahmanas became angry, why would they curse the member of Lord Krishna's own family?
即便 Brahmana 内心愤怒，他们为何要诅咒 Krishna 的自己的家族成员呢？
The Brahmanas were learned, so they must have known that it's offensive to oppose the associates of Lord Krishna.
因为 Brahmana 们，他们都是满腹经纶的，他们应该知道与至尊主的亲生同流对抗乃是冒犯之举。
The Brahmanas were. The Yadu dynasty were Krishna's own men, and they were always absorbed in thinking of Krishna.
亚杜王朝是主 Krishna 的亲人，并且他们始终心系 Krishna。
So even if somehow the Brahmanas did curse them, then that curse it could not have any effect on them.
即便 Brahmana 诅咒了他们，这个诅咒也不应该产生效果。
So Maharaj Parikshit is asking like that.
这次便是 Maharaj Parikshit 的疑问。
So the Yadus are described that they're always thinking of Krishna. So that indicates that Krishna desired that the Brahmanas become angry and curse the Yadu dynasty.
亚杜族人始终念念不忘 Krishna，这清楚地表明 Krishna 想要 Brahmana 愤怒地诅咒亚杜王朝。
So Krishna desired to remove, to get, he desired to remove his own dynasty from the earth.
Krishna 渴望把他的家人亚杜王朝从地球上撤回。
And that's why the young boys of Krishna's own family behaved in a foolish manner.
所以 Krishna 家族的少年们便以一种愚蠢的方式做出愚蠢的举动。
So we should understand from this incident that when a person shows envy and when he ridicules the devotees of Vishnu, then all of his spiritual qualifications are destroyed.
我们从此事中可以得知，当人心怀嫉妒、嘲讽威士努的奉献者，他的灵性品质便丧失了。
And he will no longer show proper respect for Lord Krishna.
他将不再对主 Krishna 展示出恰当的尊重。
When we're, if we're, if we're, if we show contempt and we try to ridicule respectable people, and if we try to misbehave with proper brahmanas, then all the good qualities of the brahmanas vanish.
倘若他展示出轻蔑之情，或者是嘲讽，冷嘲热讽，那么他对于 Brahmana 的也是展示出失礼，他会丧失他的品质。
If there's any break in the etiquette towards his devotees, then Krishna will not be pleased.
倘若对 Krishna 的奉献者失礼，Krishna 肯定会不高兴。
And Krishna will not show mercy to his own relatives and friends.
Krishna 甚至会对他的亲友失去好感。
And Krishna will arrange to destroy all those who oppose his devotees.
Krishna 会安排毁灭那些与他的奉献者对抗的人们。
And if people are so foolish, if they're like members of Krishna's own family, if they show any hatred towards the Vaishnavas, then Krishna will correct the situation.
倘若，表面上张曾是 Krishna 家族的成员，但是与 Vaishnava 为敌的话，Krishna 就会对他们产生行动。
Actually, these people who are offensive to Krishna's family, they cannot be proper members of Krishna's own dynasty.
事实上，这些人甚至不能算作是主 Krishna 王朝的后裔。
So Maharaj Parikshit asked, what was the motive for the curse? What did it consist of?
Maharaj Pariksh 王继续问道：“这诅咒的动机是什么？这诅咒的内容是什么？”
How could a disagreement ever take place among the Yadus who all shared the same goal of life?
亚度族人都共享一个生命目标，他们之间怎么会发生这种争执呢？
So Maharaj Pariksit said, please tell me all these things.
So, Parikshit 王说道：“请告诉我这一切吧。”
Yeah, we should understand that the Yadus all had the same opinion that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead and he's the goal of their life.
亚度族人意见一致，即 Krishna 是至尊人格首神，是他们的生命目标。
So Maharaj Pariksit could not see any reason for such a quarrel among the members of the Yadu dynasty.
亚度族人之间产生这样一场争执，Maharaj Pariksit 不能明白到底是什么原因。
He wanted to know the actual cause.
他想要渴望了解其中的真实缘由。
Hello? Oh, sorry. Okay, so Sukadeva Goswami said, he's replying to Maharaj Pariksit.
Shukadev Goswami 就开始回答Parikshit 王的问题。
And he said that Lord Krishna's body was everything beautiful. And he performed the most auspicious activities on the earth.
他说：“一切美丽都集中在主 Krishna 身上。”他在地球期间从事了最为吉祥的活动。
He didn't have to do anything. He was already satisfied in all desires. He didn't have any need of anything, but still he performed activities.
Krishna 不需要什么，但他仍然在从事着活动，他会一切如愿。
So he was accustomed to living in his own abode and enjoying life there.
他通常居住在自己的居所，享受着生活。
But now he wants to annihilate his dynasty because there's still some small part of his duty to be carried out on this planet.
现在他想要毁灭自身的王朝，因为他还有一小部分职责尚未履行。
So, Sukadeva Goswami is replying to Maharaj Pariksit's question about how the members of the Yadu dynasty could be cursed by the Brahmanas and thus destroy themselves in a war.
Shukadev Goswami 开始回答 Parikshit 王，询问亚度族人怎么会受到诅咒，乃至于互相残杀的问题。
So Lord Krishna himself wanted to take away his dynasty, to take them out of this earth and send them away. So he used the Brahmanas as his agent to help him do this.
就 Krishna 渴望撤回他的王朝，所以他便让 Brahmana 做他的代理。
Krishna had already demonstrated his great beauty and the strength of his wonderful form and his pastimes and pleasures to everyone on earth.
Krishna 已经向地球上的每一个人展示了他的美丽力量。他的喜乐，他的逍遥。
So he had come to kill the demons and save the devotees and re-establish the religious principles. And he'd done that successfully.
Krishna 铲除恶魔，拯救奉献者，崇教中建宗教原则的使命以大功告成。
So then Krishna desired to return to his transcendental abode along with the Yadu dynasty.
Krishna 便渴望和亚杜王朝的人们一同返回自己的居所。
So he arranged for the Brahmanas to be, for the Brahmanas to curse the Yadu dynasty.
他便安排了 Brahmana 诅咒了亚杜王朝。
Another point is that Krishna is always self-satisfied, but in order to perform his transcendental pastimes, he arranged to destroy his own dynasty.
Krishna 是永远自足的，但是为了上演他的逍遥，他安排计划毁灭他的家族。
And he did this for three purposes.
他有三个目的。
One was to put those demigods back in the heavenly planets, those demigods who had taken birth in the Yadu dynasty to assist them. He wants to put them back in the heavenly planets.
有些半神人，投生在亚杜族人来协助他。Krishna 希望他们恢复在天堂的地位。
And then secondly, he wants to re-establish the Vishnu expansions in their abodes, to put them back in their abodes, such as Vaikuntha and Swetadweep and Badarik Ashram.
第二个目的是让他的 Vishnu 的权限扩展，恢复他回到他们的居所，比如 Vaikuntha、Shitadweep 和 Badarika Ashram。
And the third thing was to remove himself from the vision of the material world, along with his eternal associate.
第三个目的是把他自己和他的永恒同游们从物质世界的视线中。撤走。
So Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Prabhupada, he made several remarks about the destruction of the Yadu dynasty.
Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 就对亚德王朝的毁灭讲过几次话。
And he says that many so-called religious persons have fallen down by committing the second offense in chanting the holy name.
他说：“许多所谓宗教人士因违反了唱诵圣名十诫的第二条，所以而堕落了。
Yeah, they consider that another living entity can be equal to Lord Vishnu. Although
”
Lord
他们。
Vishnu is the Supreme Lord, they think someone is equal to him.
虽然 Vishnu 是至尊主，他们却以为。某个生物体可以和它，同等。
Yeah, the impersonalists, the Mayavadi, they think that the material energy is equal to the spiritual energy.
非人格主义者马哈瓦迪错误地认为主的物质能量和他的灵性能量一样。
So they think that the ordinary living entities are equal with the Supreme Lord.
他们把普通生物视作和至尊主同等。
And they think that Krishna comes, he's just another part of Maya.
他们以为 Krishna 降临只是 Maya 的另一个特征。
Well, this is very unfortunate misunderstanding. It means such people will never understand God.
这是最不幸的曲解。这种曲解使人永远无法理解神。
And these people also think that the members of the Yadu dynasty are equal to Krishna.
这些人也误以为亚都族人和 Krishna 都相等。
And they think that all the descendants of Krishna's family are equal to Krishna himself.
他们也会认为 Krishna 家族的后裔和 Krishna 本人一样。
So, if the Yadu dynasty would stay on the earth, it would be a big problem to spiritual understanding.
倘若亚度王朝继续在地球存在下去，必然会成为灵性知识之途上的巨大障碍。
So, Lord Krishna wanted to counteract that danger to the world.
所以，Krishna 想要抵消这给世人带来的危险。
He doesn't want people to think that Vishnu and the family of Vishnu are equal. So that's why Lord Krishna decided to crush the Yadu family.
他不希望人们把威士努和威士努的家族相提并论，所以决定粉碎亚度家族。
Lord Krishna is always kind to his devotees. But whenever the descendants of the Lord's family, when they become inimical or indifferent to him, and when they don't show love for his pure devotees or make friendship with his servants, then these family members are a problem.
Krishna 永远钟爱奉献者，但是每当主 Krishna 的家族后裔变得敌视或漠视他，不热爱他的纯粹奉献者，或不与他的仆人建立友谊，主的这些所谓家族成员便成为重重障碍。
There's a danger that ignorant people will worship such people. We will consider them as close associates of Krishna.
愚昧无知的人会将会崇拜这些心怀敌意的人，把他们当做 Krishna 的亲密同友，予以崇敬。
Just like somebody may think, well, Kamsa is the uncle of Krishna. So he's also a faithful servant of Krishna.
比如，有的人以为 Kamsa 是 Krishna 的舅舅，就认为他是 Krishna 的忠实仆人。
So such evil people, they will oppose Krishna. They will.
So, 这些邪恶之人也许会反对 Krishna。
But common people may think these are the intimate associates of Krishna.
但普通人会以为这些人都是 Krishna 的亲密的同友啊。
And they may think that those people who are actually his surrendered Someone may think that those people who are envious of Krishna and who are enemies of Krishna, that they're his surrendered dependent in his own family.
有些人会，误以为，那些邪恶之人因为诞生在 Krishna 的家族当中，所以他们是臣服 Krishna 的，依靠他的。
So the purpose in removing the Yadu dynasty was to remove the understanding that Mayavadi wants to see everything as one in all respects.
毁灭亚度王朝的目的在于根除马尔瓦蒂的错误逻辑，他们渴望视万物唯一。
And it removes also the understanding that the enemies of Krishna's devotees can be Lord Krishna's intimate family member.
他们会错误地声称，Krishna 的奉献者的敌人可以是 Krishna 亲密的家族成员。
Okay, how are we doing on time? Oh yeah, we have a little more time. Okay, so the great sages, there were many great sages, and with Narada Muni and others, they were doing rituals that give a lot of pious results, bring great happiness, and take away sin.
有一次，有很多伟大的圣人，包括纳尔德穆尼在内，他们做了很多果报性仪式典礼，得到了丰厚的虔诚结果，为世界带来幸福快乐，带走卡比年代的罪恶。
So the sages did these rituals in the homes of the Yadus.
这些圣人就在亚度族人的家中举行了仪式。
And Lord Krishna was staying in the home of Vasudeva's father.
Krishna 就留在他的父亲 Vasudeva 家中。
So at that time, Lord Krishna, with great respect, he sent the sages off at the end of the ceremony, and they went to the holy place called Pindaraka.
Krishna 在仪式结束后，恭恭敬敬送走诸位圣人，圣人们前往圣地 Pindaraka。
So this is the beginning of the story of the curse of the Brahmins against the Yadu dynasty, which was the desire of Lord Krishna.
故事便这样开始了。Brahmana 们，后面就将诅咒亚度族人。
So certain religious rituals, like the Ashwamedha Yajna, that gives a lot of pious reactions.
某些宗教仪式，例如 Ashwamedha Yajna，会产生许多虔诚的反应。
But if you do things like just take care of your children, that may give you some pleasure in the present only, but doesn't give you any spiritual benefit. It doesn't take away sinful reaction.
另一方面，诸如照顾孩子的活动，只会在当下带来眼前的快乐，不能带来灵性的好处。
But rituals which are performed as an atonement that can take away sinful reactions.
而为了赎罪而得以施行的仪式，则会带走种种的罪恶反应。
So the rituals which are being described here, they produced abundant pious results and they produced a great happiness.
在这里描述的仪式，他们是虔诚的，会带产生出大量的虔诚结果和巨大喜乐。
And they were so powerful that just glorifying these rituals took away their sinful reactions of Kali Yuga.
他们十分强劲有力，人们只是荣耀这些仪式，便可超脱咖喱年代的罪恶反应。
So the sages came to Vasudeva's house to perform these religious rituals, and they were satisfied, they were given a lot of gifts, and then they were sent by Krishna to go to Pindaraka.
圣人们聚集在 Vasudeva 的家中，从事这些吉祥的宗教活动。他们得到了丰厚的厚礼，感到心满意足。然后他们听从 Krishna 派遣去了 Pindaraka。
Yeah, today the current name of this place is Bandarak. And it's on the coast. It's 2 miles from the Arabian Sea on the coast of Gujarat.
Pindaraka，它距离阿拉伯海2英里远，位于古吉拉特海滨。
The Lord Krishna is described as being the form of time or the super soul.
这 Krishna 被描述为时间的形体或超灵。
Just like in the 11th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna shows Arjuna his form as time.
就像在《博伽梵歌》第11章，Krishna 向 Arjuna 揭示了他本人的时间形象。
And how Lord Krishna appeared on the battlefield at Kurukshetra to destroy all the kings and armies which were burdening the earth.
Krishna 显现在库鲁切特战场，目的是消灭给地球造成重负的君主、君王和军队。
So Lord Krishna was staying in his father's home, and he is time personified. So this shows us that time was approaching for the destruction of his own dynasty, according to his design.
Krishna 住在他父亲 Vasudeva 家中，表明时间在按照他的意愿步步逼近，毁灭他自身的王朝。
Okay. So we will stop here. Ask if there's any question.
今天晚上我们讲到这里，接下来是回答问题的时间。我先读一下这个问题。顶拜 Guru 和奉献者在圣典博伽瓦坛1.3.1 Sutta 说道，在创造的一开始，至尊主先扩展出主宰化身，展示物质创造所需要的一切原料，因此首先就有了对构成物世界的16种原材料创造。在药旨中，帕帕说，这个物质创造实体首先分为5种粗糙的物质元素和11种工作感官16部分，这二者是一回事吗？如何理解这第二句话？There are some questions about Srimad Bhagavatam. So in 1.3.1, Krishna is the fountainhead of all the incarnation. Sutta said, "In the beginning of the creation, the Lord first expanded Himself in the universal form of the Purusha incarnation, and manifested all the ingredients for the material creation. And thus, at first, there was the creation of the 16 principles of material action. And then." In the purport, Srila Prabhupada said, this Mahatattva can be divided into 5 gross material elements and 11 working senses, the 16 parts. So the question is that, is it the same? Yeah, so the question is about Srimad Bhagavatam 1.3.1.
So, what's the question?
The question is that in the purport, Srila Prabhupada said, in the translation, it is said that at first there was the creation of the 16 principles of material action. And then in the purport, Srila Prabhupada said,
Haribo.
Hare Krishna.
Yeah, I couldn't hear what Prabhupada said.
Yeah, Srila Prabhupada said, primarily, this Mahatattva is divided into 16 parts, namely the five gross material elements and the 11 working instruments or senses. So how can we understand this?
Well, I know how you can't understand. Well, I don't see why you can't understand it.
In the translation, it said the 16 principles of material action. Is it the same with the these 16?
Yeah.
The same.
Yeah, the five gross elements. Five senses, the mind. Yeah, it's the same.
So how can we understand that there are five gross material elements from five senses, working senses are in the Mahatattva?
Well, the Mahatattva is it, and the unmanifest state is the Pradhan. And when it becomes manifest, that's the Mahatattva. So the Mahatattva is like the Khichdi. All the different elements are mixed together. The five gross elements, the five senses, the five knowledge acquiring senses, five working senses, and you may have the wife.
故事说就是在，一开始是 Pradhan 阶段，然后是，Mahatattva，在 Mahatattva 呢，就像 Khichdi 粥一样，就有所有的这些元素，就包括这五个粗糙的元素，还有五个工作感官、五个活动感官、五个获取知识的感官。So, like the eyes, ears, and legs are there in the Mahatattva?我看问题二，圣殿不要把谈一点三点二，Gabu Dakshai Vishnu 扩展出 Chiu Dakshai Vishnu 名叫 Hari，宇宙中所有化身都从他那里展示出来。而1.3.5说这个形象主宰化身的第二个展示，是宇宙多种化身的源头和种子。请问 Guru，到底是哪位 Vishnu 展示出化身？So the second question, Maharaj, is
Yeah.
about the incarnation in the Srimad Bhagavatam 1.3.2. It says Garbhodakshaya Vishnu then expand into Chiodakshaya Vishnu. He's called Hari, an old incarnation of the universe comes from him. And then in the 1.3.5, it says this form, the second expansion of the Mahapurush, he is the source and the seed of the old various incarnation of the universe. So the question is about there are two so the question is about All the incarnation of the universe comes from Gabdakshai Vishnu or Chiodakshai Vishnu.
Well, there's no difference. Chirodakshai Vishnu, Garbhodakshai Vishnu. They're both the Purusha avatars. They're both the personality of Godhead. Doesn't make any difference.
所以，故事说就是，Garbhodakshai Vishnu 和 Chiodakshai Vishnu 他们都是人格守神，他们没有什么区别。第三个问题是瓦坛1.4.14说，Avasvata Manu 统治期间，在4个年代循环运行的第28个循环中出现了。第二个年代、第三个年代顺序颠倒情况，在那年代正是 Krishna 亲自降临。So the second part of question is that in Vaivasvata Mata, the ruler of Vaivasvata Manu, there are the four yoga, One point in 1.4.14. So there is a during the regime of Vaivasvata Manu, there was an overlapping of the 28th round of the four millennium, and the third millennium appeared prior to the second. In that particular millennium, Lord Shri Krishna also descends. So the question is about, so when did the Lord Krishna descend?
Lord Krishna descended. Well, when the demigods went and called for him to come, right? When they went to Lord Brahma, and Lord Brahma meditated on Lord Vishnu, and Lord Vishnu told them all to go and take birth in the Yadu dynasty. And the Lord said, I'm also coming there.
半神人去找主威士奴的时候，主威士奴就告诉他们说，让这个半神都纷纷在亚度王朝中显现。你看。下一个问题是 Vaishnavi Vani 说，Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj。Out of the three specific reasons to destroy the Yadu dynasty, one reason is to put the demigods back in heavenly planets. So does it mean that some of the members of Yadu dynasty did not go back to the spiritual world along with Krishna? Another question is, does Krishna can appear simultaneously in different universes of the material worlds? Or does he appear only in one universe? Thank you, Guru Maharaj, for your class. Vaishnavani 说，Guru Maharaj，在毁灭亚度王朝的3个原因当中，一个原因是让半神人回到天堂星球。那是不是说亚度王朝的有的成员没有回到灵异世界，和 Krishna 一起回去？另一个问题是，Krishna 同时可不可以同时显现在许多宇宙当中？
Yeah, some of them were demigods, so they went back to the heavenly planets.
是的，有些亚度王朝成员是半神，所以他们回了天堂。
They didn't all go back to Godhead.
他们并不都回到灵性世界，回到神首那里了。
But they were very elevated souls. They were demigods, and they'd come to take part in Krishna's pastime.
但他们都是非常崇高的灵魂，他们来和参加 Krishna 的消时光。
嗯。
The second question is, can Krishna appear simultaneously in different universes of the material world, or does he appear only in one universe?
Well, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, will appear only in one universe at a time.
Sorry.
Krishna, who is the
Yeah.
Supreme Personality of Godhead, the original Supreme Personality of Godhead, Swayam Bhagavan Krishna, he will appear in one universe at a time.
Oh, 就是 Krishna 是原初的至尊性格神首 Swayam Bhagavan，他会。在那个时候显现在一个宇宙。
He has a plan. He has to go to different universes, so he will go from one universe to another. He performs his pastimes with his different devotees.
他会就是在不同的时间去不同的宇宙，和他的奉献者在一起。
There's a schedule. That's like the Lord's incarnation in different places.
所以有一个计划，就像主，就像在化身，就显现在不同的地方。OK，that's all the question.
All right, so we'll stop here.
我今天晚上就讲到这里。
我们
Thank you, Mother.
感谢和妈妈的那一次给我们欢迎，我们感谢和妈妈的支持，感谢大家的那一次，感谢所有的奉献者，明天我们就和你们晚安，哈利克什纳。
Thank you, Maharaj. Srila Bhakti Vipindanath Narasimha Ki Jai.